the way we access our settings on the 250 8450 is by hitting our menu button. We bring up our interface for our cameras and HDMI, and we also have a settings button right there that we can hit, where we've got system, camera, and copyright. And basically, system is just that. We can update the system, we can reset it, we can change the language if necessary. The copyright basically tells us what version of the firmware and serial number of the unit is installed in the truck. But where, for our purposes, where we're going to get the most action is under camera. And now we can choose a number of different options. Our reverse camera option allows us to choose between which camera we see when we put the truck in reverse. Now keep in mind that you can always trigger the aftermarket rear camera from our camera screen. When we bring up our menu, we hit camera, touch the screen, we can always bring up that fifth wheel camera or trailer camera, whatever type of camera you've plugged into that rear input. But you can also make that the default when you put it in reverse. So right now we've chosen aftermarket, we put it in reverse, and now we've got our fifth wheel camera as the default. If we choose OEM and go back out of that menu, let's say go to the home screen, we choose OEM, and now we see our factory tailgate camera instead of that fifth wheel. So this is, that one's really an option, mainly for when we're backing into a fifth wheel situation, or you know, your camera's on the back side of the trailer you're towing. You can choose that aftermarket camera and always access that when the truck goes into reverse. The other options are front camera trigger by speed, on or off, left cam and right cam triggers with turn signals, and the left-right cam trigger only in motion. And the way that these work is the front cam trigger by speed is going to turn the front camera on below 6-8 miles an hour. So you, when you come up to your parking stall, the camera comes on automatically and you can inch your way into a parking stall or garage, etc. The left and right camera trigger by turn signals. When we hit the left camera or left turn signal, right turn signal, those will come on automatically and display on the screen. And the left-right camera trigger only in motion allows us to use those left and right cameras. But let's say when we come up to a stop, you know, to a stoplight and our turn signal's on, we don't want to continue to watch the left-hand camera, let's say, the entire time we're sitting at a light. The trigger only in motion will allow us to turn on that trigger or turn on that camera while we're moving, and then when we stop, it'll default back to our home screen, and then you can do all your radio or media options and get that display on the screen. And then once you're up and running again and your turn signal's still on, you'll be able to see that turn signal camera while the vehicle's in motion. So that's a quick overview of the camera settings on the 250 8450. Now we'll show you what this is like on the road. One of the great things about the 250 8450 camera system is the way that you can utilize these cameras in heavy traffic, or you know, especially if you're towing, and anybody that's driven heavy-duty truck like this. This is a 2016 Silverado 3500 Dually Duramax diesel. If you're towing a fifth-wheel trailer with this, things can get awful crowded awful quickly. And this system allows us a number of different ways to monitor our camera system. We've got it triggered so that our turn signals will automatically bring up our cameras. In this case, I want to change lanes, moving off to my left, check my mirrors, check my camera. I make my turn, cancel my signals, and we go right back to navigation. And now, as I'm in the left lane, let's say I want to monitor my right-hand camera for blind spot. We hit our back button, which brings up our front camera, touch the screen, bring up our right-hand camera, and now we can monitor our blind spot on that right-hand side. And depending on your situation, this may be a great safety feature as you're towing, especially in a crowded traffic situation where you really got to keep an eye on what's going on around you. Again, we can use this, use any camera in this mode as well. So we can go to our left camera, bring that up. We can bring up our front camera, and we can bring up our right-hand camera. Again, we can look at any view around the truck, except the factory rear camera does not, we don't override the operation of that camera, so that is unavailable while we are driving. That's only available while we're in reverse. But any of the other cameras that we installed, we can view in action, including our rear. Let's say we're pulling our fifth wheel down the road, we can monitor our fifth wheel connection. And coming soon, we'll have a wireless camera that will allow us to put a wireless camera, let's say inside of a horse trailer or on the backside of our trailer that we're towing behind the truck. And then we'd be able to monitor that camera, again, on demand by touching the screen, hitting that rear camera input, and that'd be a lifesaver to monitor our livestock, horses, toy trailer, whatever we're towing behind us. We're making another lane change here. There's my right turn signal. Change lanes. And now let's say I want to monitor my left side blind spot. There's our left side as we're getting past. And we can monitor our front camera and view that vehicle ahead of us. Now keep in mind too, our left and right cameras, the view out of these things is about 160 degrees. So as you see these vehicles go by, we're seeing far more than a normal, you know, static 90 degree or 110 degree camera. We're seeing a full 160 degrees off of our left-hand side. In fact, we're seeing the front of that car up until he's about at the front of our truck. So we've got essentially a fisheye view out of our left and right side cameras. It's pretty amazing to see it in action, and the increase in safety is dramatic. So we can get an idea of how useful the front camera can be, especially in a parking situation. We'll go ahead and pull out of a parking lot and then come back into it so we can demonstrate what a huge improvement on front visibility that camera gives us. Again, remember our turn signal cameras are going to come on as we're signaling out of our lot here. We'll merge into traffic. Here's our right turn signal to get in another lane, and left turn signal back into our parking lot. So will come in and pull up behind a vehicle into our parking stall so you can see exactly what you're missing out of the front view on this big Duramax 3500 Dually Silverado. So we come into the parking lot. We'll find our parking space, and as we slow down to pull into our stall, our front camera is going to come on automatically, and you'll be able to see in real time as we pull up to the back of this car. You can see that we can get within inches of the back bumper of this thing, and right now over the top of that hood, you can't even see the bottom of the back windshield. All we can see are the top of the headrests in the car in front of us, yet you can see you're 6 inches away from that bumper out of that front camera. So if you can imagine that we're missing the entire back half of that car in our blind spot out the front of this truck, you can see what a huge advantage that would make having that front camera. To do our HDMI cable input in our center glove box, we remove this black plastic center tray cover and remove the panel underneath it. I'll show you how that works here. We pull that up, and you can see we've got a little panel there with five Phillips screws on it. We removed that and simply added a notch in the corner of the forward edge of that right side. And now we can pull out, gosh, 2.5 feet of cable, more than enough to be able to give us an easy reach to our phone and do our HDMI connection. And then if we want to get that out of the way, we can simply feed it all back in, keep it out of the way when we're not using it, and it turns out to be a very clean install. And then when you put the little pocket that goes back in there, You just about can't see it when you're sitting on the sitting in the driver's seat. It's a very, very clean install. Let's say you're driving down the road, you're listening to your Bluetooth music selection or Pandora, whatever you've got going on the phone. You can listen to that via Bluetooth on the unit, and then when you go over to your HDMI input, keep in mind that we're going to mirror everything that's currently on the phone. So we've got that exact same output on our factory screen, which gives us the ability. Let's say we want to bring up our Waze app and have all of our information for police action, accidents, traffic, etc. on our screen at the same time we're listening to our audio track. It gives you a completely unlimited ability to use any app on the phone in conjunction with the factory navigation. Now keep in mind, factory nav is great, but Waze gives us a completely different overview of the traffic situation around our location, and takes it to a different level than the factory navigation. Here's YouTube. We play it. We got full audio and the ability to view any video source we want. Of course, while we're stopped and the vehicle's in park, of course. But we've got full control, so if we want to speed that up or scrub to a different spot of the video, works absolutely perfectly. It's just a beautiful picture, and of course we get all our our audio as well, in perfect sync. Hit our Netflix icon, bring that up, let it log in. Log in to your account. Here's, let's watch Zootopia. Perfect video, perfect audio, and again, we can scrub wherever we want to go in the movie.
Please, there's got to be somebody to find my Emmy.
This is Autotel.
I will find him.
Another great app you might consider using on the phone via the HDMI input is Slingbox. If you have a Slingbox at home, bring up the Sling Player app and hit connect, and now you can watch your home TV, hit your use your remote control, do all of your operations on the home TV or the home tuner, just as you would if you're sitting on your couch with your remote control in your hand. So it's absolutely awesome video. There's your output on the phone and the screen. It's absolutely a great option. And again, you can use the remote control. Oh, there's our navigation coming over the top of it. Let's use our remote control. Let's say we want to change channel. We can go to channel 107. There we go. We can watch our news, whatever we want to do. It's a great option. And again, this factory screen, I can't say enough about this factory screen. It's absolutely perfect. One of the best screens I've ever seen in a vehicle. Another great use for our Bluetooth and HDMI system is to play videos that are contained on the phone or the device, the laptop, a tablet or a phone device that has HDMI. Let's say we want to watch something that's, a video that's already on the phone. Here in this case, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. There we go. We've got perfectly acceptable video with Bluetooth audio that's perfectly synced and gives us another option for video on our factory 8-inch touchscreen. To give you an idea of the quality of this factory screen, we brought up our website and you can pretty much read text as you'd be able to on any high resolution screen on the unit itself. It's pretty amazing. The pixel density of the factory screen is very high, and it gives you more options to for instance use this as an extension of your display, your device display, I should say, because pretty much everything that you'd expect to see, on a browser, you can read on this display. It's absolutely great.